Hi guys, I'm Karina and welcome to my channel. So this is the first time I'm renting an apartment and honestly, I've been so hesitant on hanging anything on these walls because if you guys don't know, when you are getting out of a rental unit, like when you're leaving, you have to return it back to them in the same condition that you found it in. But now it's getting to the point where I'm kind of sick of living in an apartment with bare walls. So I started creating some wall art pieces to make this house feel more like a home again. And today I will share these three wall art decor pieces that I recently created. I'm obsessed with them and I hope this video inspires you in some way or another. But before we move on, make sure to hit the subscribe button because I post new videos every single week. Now let's dive right into these projects because I love them and I'm sure you will too. In order to make the tassel, I'm gonna take a 6-inch piece of string and I'm gonna tape it to a rectangular surface. Now I'll wrap the yarn vertically 20 times. Cut off all the loops at the end of the tassel with a pair of scissors. Leave a 1-inch gap from the knot that we tied earlier and tie another knot with a piece of string just like this. Now trim off all the tassels to the desired length. Make 5 more tassels just like this and then match them to the one that we just trimmed so that all of them are the same size. As for the beads, I went to Michael's and I found these 2 packets of wooden beads for $6 each, but I don't want to spend so much money on it, so I went to the dollar store and I found these styrofoam balls for just $1.25. Then I just painted all the styrofoam balls with black acrylic paint. Once the paint dried off completely, I took a knitting needle and I poked a hole through all the balls. Now keep those balls aside and then take 5 pieces of strings which are 14 to 16 inches long and then tie a loop on one end just like this. Once all the loops are made, take the 2 strings that we left on top of the tassel and put it through the loop and tie it together. Tie another loop at a 5-inch distance from the tassel on one of the strings and add another tassel to that and just tie it through the loop. But make sure you do this only for one of the strings and not all 5 of them. So now it's time to slide all the balls through the yarn and in order to make this easy, I'm just gonna wrap some tape at the end of each yarn. So this creates a sharp point which makes it very easy for us to slide the yarn through the ball. Now I'll make a knot at a 3-inch distance from the tassel just to make sure that the ball doesn't slide down beyond that point. I'm gonna repeat the same steps for all the other 4 strings as well, but the only difference here will be about where I tie the knot. So for the first and last string, I'm gonna tie a knot at a 5-inch distance from the tassel. So this is the 3rd and the 5th string of the wall art and I'm gonna place the 4th string right between that just to mark the point that I would want the ball to stop in order to make a proper V shape and that's where I'm gonna tie the knot. Now that all 5 strings are done, it's time to work on the branch. And I found this piece of branch at a park that I just went to and I'm gonna paint it with some silver acrylic paint that I got from Michael's. I'll tie a string at the end of the branch and I'm just going to create a double knot and cut off the extra yarn. I'm going to mark the distance between the ball and the branch and I'll use that same distance to tie a knot for the first string as well. Now I'll secure the other 3 strings on the branch as well. I'll take another piece of string that is 16 inches long and I'll tie a knot at the start and end of the branch just like this. that's it. We're done making this wall art. It was so easy to make, and I absolutely love how this looks. Found this memo board at IKEA and it was only $8, but the only downside was that it came with a white rim, but the interiors in my room are all black, so I had to paint this with some black acrylic paint. I purchased this marble contact paper from Amazon. I absolutely love it. It looks really good. It's a good size and it wasn't that expensive as well. If you guys want to purchase it, I'm going to link it in the description box down below. At first, I took the measurements of the memo board, excluding the border, and now I'm going to use those dimensions to cut this marble contact paper as well. Now I'm going to stick the marble paper on the cork board, and I'm going to work with very small sections just to avoid any air bubbles that can be formed. I got printouts of all the images I wanted to put on the memo board, but I wanted to add a black border as well. So I'm just gonna stick all these images on a big black chart paper and cut it out along with the border. I stuck one of the pieces with a push pin, but then I realized that the marble print will actually show all the holes that I make on the memo board. So then I bought this instant tack from the dollar store, and I'm gonna use this to stick all the other prints now. And that's it. I can't believe I made this $8 memo board look like an amazing wall art piece. This leaf in a park, and I love that it has all these ridges on the back, so that's a side that I'm going to use. I'm going to use this silver metallic paint and apply a very thin coat all over the leaf. Once the first coat has been dried off, I'm going to apply a second coat on top of that. I took a square sheet of textured paper and splattered some black paint all over it. This was a lot of fun because all I had to do was dip my brush in some paint and then just flick the brush tip all over the paper. I got this frame from IKEA just for $5, and this is what I'm going to stick the artwork on. Once the leaf has dried off completely, I'm just going to use a double-sided tape to stick it on the artwork. But I'm going to use a really thick double-sided tape since I want the leaf to pop up above the artwork. Just to add a little more depth, I'm going to brush some black acrylic paint to the edges of the leaf. I really love how this wall art piece turned out. Wall art video. I hope you enjoyed watching those three DIY projects, and I will link as many of the supplies that I used in the description box below. And have a wonderful rest of your day, and you'll see me very soon in my next video. Bye.